Good afternoon, children. In this video, I have given you syllabus of computer application. In computer application, class 9th and 10th, your subject is computer application. When you go in class 11th and 12th, it is computer science. Here, computer application, class 9th, I have given you revised syllabus of 2020-21. This syllabus of midterm. Introduction to object-oriented programming language is your first chapter. An introduction to Java I have given you, but it is merged in chapter 1. Then second is elementary concept of object and class. And third is values and data types. And fourth is operators and expression. Three chapters I have already completed. Fourth chapter is going on. Fourth chapter, operators and expression. I have given you all the assignment related to operators and expression. Two chapters are left, input in Java and mathematical library function. On next video, I will start with mathematical library function. Because mathematical library function and arithmetic expression both are related. So, from next turn, I give you mathematical library function. Then onwards we start input in Java. Clear? I have already given you assignment. You have to write all the assignment in your separate notebook. Here I explain you about the project of computer application. In computer application, in class 9th and 10th, ICSC, your subject marks are 200. 100 is your internal marks and 100 marks question paper. In 100 internal marks, it is divided into two parts. 50 marks programming file. In programming file, you have to prepare one separate file, that is interleave file, cover with brown paper, take a printout of computer application year 2020-21, class 9th, write down your section and then you in first page you will write acknowledgement. After acknowledgement, I will give you at least 15 questions to cover all the topics. In this video, in assignment, I have given you two questions. You start writing, after acknowledgement, you start writing your program. First, you write down problem, then you write down program. After this, the next is variable description. So, one question divided into 15 marks. In this programming file, 15 questions I will give you in assignment. All the questions you will write it clearly, children. Then 100 marks your question paper. 100 marks question paper is divided into two sections, section A and section B. Section A is your 40 marks. In 40 marks, question 1, that is objective, 2 marks questions are there, that is 10 marks. Then question 2, again 10 marks, 10 questions are there of 2 marks. Then question 3, that is 20 marks. In 20 marks, all the questions of like expression, postfix and prefix. These type of questions are there. Then 60 marks are left. In 60 marks, that is section B. In section B, all the programs are there. You have 6 programs. You have to write only 4. Choose any 4 out of 6. In that 4, each of 15 marks. So that is 60 marks are there. Each 15 marks program, 5 marks of your program, 5 marks of your comments, and 5 marks of variable description. On next video, I will explain you how to write the expression, how to write the variable description, and how to write the command. Clear? So, the question is divided into 15 marks. You have to complete this programming file. 15 questions you are write it, and then when I explain you variable description, then you are going to write it variable description. Variable description, that is written in the plain page. So you have to use interleaf pages. In interleaf pages, one side problem, then you are going to write program, and the plain side you will write the variable description. Clear? So this is of programming file. 50 marks is there. Then 50 marks of assignment and class performance. In class performance or in assignment, whatever assignment I have given you in each video, that you have to note it down. Clear? So 200 marks are there. 100 is internal sent by the college, and 100 whatever you scored in your exam. So 200 average is calculated in your report card. Clear children? Any doubt or anything, then you ask when the school reopens. Okay. God bless you. Yes, children, about programming file, computer application, class 9th, problem 1. Write a program to calculate parameter of a circle whose radius is given 7.5. So first you are going to write class, circle, curly braces open. I have already explained you. You will write it after, or you will write it on the next line. Then public static void main, string as, square bracket, bracket close, again curly braces open. Then your main method is starting, double radius. Why we have taken double data type? Because that is in decimal. So the data type is double. Radius is your identifier, equals to 7.5. 7.5 radius I have stored in radius variable. Then next we have to calculate the parameter. So when it is double, the next parameter is also double, because the value comes in decimal. This 2 multiplied by 3.141, that is a pi value, all of you know, multiplied by radius. So I used formula here, and this stored in parameter. This is your identifier. If I have written the identifier in uppercase or lowercase mix, so you have to also write it in uppercase and lowercase. We remember, because in identifier, if you have written all the identifier, whatever you opted here, and in printing, if it is changed, then you will not compile the program and it give you a syntax error. So system.out.println, within double quotes, whatever is in within double quote, that is computer will print it as it is. So parameter of a circle. Plus, you are not going to write it if you have subtract or multiply or any other mathematical operator. No, always you have to write it plus, because that is a syntax of system.out.print. So parameter of a circle, it comes as it is on the screen. Then parameter, whatever value is calculated, it give you output, it is parameter. So see, parameter here, whatever I have assigned it, same I have assigned it here, because it gives you output. Then we compile this program. So this program, it is written programming file. So you have to write it in your programming file. And each video I will give you programming file written there, and you have to write it in programming file. Then next problem 2, write a program to convert temperature 98.6 Fahrenheit into degree Celsius. So class temp, public static void, then Fahrenheit, I stored it in double 98.6, because decimal value, if decimal value is there, that is in always double. If it is simple 98, then it is integer int. So double Celsius. Then Celsius we are going to calculate it. 5, formula is 5 multiplied by Fahrenheit minus 32 divided by 9. We apply the formula and the value is stored in Celsius. So system.out.print, the Fahrenheit degree in Celsius, it is in double quotes, it print on the screen as it is, plus Celsius. So when you compile this program, in output you will see the Fahrenheit degree in Celsius equal to whatever value is calculated, it comes. So both the programs, you will write it in your programming file. In assignment, I will give you some questions. Afterwards, I will write it programming file. So where I have written programming file, those questions you will note down in your file. From today, I have given you programming file questions, and you start writing both the question in your file. Prepare a file, interleave, cover with white cover, take the printout of computer application, your name, class, and then write it acknowledgement and start writing these program. On next video, I have explained with variable description. So you have to write down variable description in the plain page, and program problem and program in a rule page. Clear? So 15 programs, your file complete. All the chapters and all the topics are covered in these 15 questions. Okay, good day, children.